Okay, there are our shapes. Now it's time to color them in, and how I color them in is using a couple of different kinds of markers. You could use whatever you have. I do have pit pens, and I have used them to color them in, but the colors that I have are all fairly dark. so I don't use them all the time. I also use my Letraset aqua markers, and I know you're all saying, but they're water-based. They are. Funny enough, I haven't had too much of a problem with the ink running when I go to collage them in. It might be because I try not to get any of the collage glue on top of the embellishment. And if I do, I'm really quick about it and, you know, don't fuss with it too much and keep brushing over it, then it will run. Most of the time, it's not a problem. So now I'm going to color these in and with the colored markers, and I will do some highlights in each with my Uniball Signo gel pen, white gel pen. And I'm going to fast forward through that, and we'll be back. Okay, once you get them all colored, then you just cut them out. I always cut them apart first. This old book text is really fragile, so I need to be more careful with it than I normally would. Oops. See what I mean? Okay. Sometimes if you get a really old book, the paper is pretty fragile. So I always cut them out, and I leave about, I don't know, an eighth of an inch, a quarter, not more than a quarter of an inch of the security envelope, book text, or whatever, around the edge of the drawing. I don't cut it right up to the edge of the drawing. I just think it makes it more interesting when you collage it into a page. Like that. So I'm going to cut all these out, and I'll be back. Okay, so now they're all cut out, and then what I do is I separate them into jars. These are all my sort of geometric shapes in here. These are all my bugs. And these are Talenti gelato containers. Yes, because I like gelato. And then this is one of those new blue ball canning jars. And this is all of my doodle flowers. And then when I want them to embellish an art journal page or a art journal cover or something else, I have them. So that's how you make those. I hope it helps you all. Experiment with different kinds of paper and different kind of images. Let me know what you find that works and doesn't, and let's share some ideas. And don't forget to go out today and do something nice for yourself. You deserve it. See you later.